The heat is on, and it's on the street. Is that how the song goes?
The heat is on.
I have to find that and play it now. Hey, this is the Risk Control Show. You're on with Steve and Matt, and if you can't figure out what we're talking about, well, then who sung that song?
Kenny Loggins, right?
Kenny Loggins?
The heat yeah, I think it was
yeah,
Kenny
I'm gonna
Loggins.
Look it up right now, you know? Anyway. yep, there it comes. I'm grab this and move it over
Are
here
you
until
gonna
I
play
find it. I'm gonna try and find it. But heat illness, folks. Heat wave is here, right?
Oh yeah, it's. I mean, it's been like uncomfortably hot for the last, I'd say, week or so, and I'm seeing reports that this heat wave could actually last for a month. And I'm like, really, a month? They know, like with all the doubts we have about meteorologists and weather people, they can tell us for sure this is going to last for a month. But I guess they're not really going out on a bridge too far, considering it's California in mid to late July, are they?
Yeah, probably not. Well, all across the country, I mean, Midwest, desert. Mm-hmm. What about the hottest place on earth here, Death Valley? Think it's going to be hot there, Matt?
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Although you know what, they actually there's a report that they now think there's a spot in Libya that had the higher temperature that broke the record of 134 degrees that was set by Death Valley. But but they can't confirm it. So I think Death Valley is still the official record holder.
Record holder since 1979 when they started keeping records.
You would think, but actually I'd have to check. I don't have that in front of me. I think that Death Valley record was set in 1916.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, that's quite a while ago, though. Makes me wonder about the legitimacy of that, right?
Well,
they didn't have the same temperature.
I think there's been some speculation as to when all these records were being kept in heat, but we're not gonna. I don't want to
yeah.
dive too deep.
I don't want to be there. The one thing I know, Steve, is no matter if there's something even approaching a record, I don't want to be there.
Like in Vegas this past weekend or two, 118, 119. Ooh. I was out there once when it was like 119, 120, and I gotta say, it was hot. It was really
hot. Oh, yeah.
You could literally fry that egg on that concrete, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And it begs that question, you know, older folks that were, I mean, I'm talking really older, that are using walkers and cane things, they fall and then they get terrible, terrible skin burns.
Yeah.
And
yeah, the concrete is upwards of like 150, 160 degrees.
Yeah.
Even higher, depending on how long it's been out there, the time of the day. It's a very, it's a very serious, very serious possibility for anybody.
When I took my daughter on that road trip through down to Texas and down the 10, it was like Tire Shredder Highway. I mean, everybody was blowing tires
right.
and catching fire. And I'm just like, I'm going to go drive slow.
Don't overheat the tires.
Out,
yeah.
So why does all this heat matter, folks? Well, heat illness. And as you know, Cal OSHA is pulling in the indoor heat illness standard. That means your warehouses, and if you got like an auto repair shop, those service bays and things that don't really have a lot of cooling to them, they're also part of the heat illness standard. I never understood why it mattered. You know, if you're inside, outside, if the temperature is really hot, then it matters.
Right. I mean, I picture, for instance, let's say it's 75 degrees outside, right? Like it's a spring day and it's 75 degrees, but you're working in a metal warehouse. Like it's the primary constructive material, especially the roof, is there's a lot of metal in the construction. And inside, it could be a good 10 degrees hotter just from the sun hitting that. And you're working in an interior ambient temperature that's well over the standard that OSHA sets for heat conditions. Even though it's 75 outside, but if you're not testing for that, you wake up in the morning and you look at your phone app like we all do and say, oh, how hot's it going to be? Oh, 75 degrees, I'll be fine. No, yeah, tell that to someone getting into a hot car that's been sitting out in the sun. Yeah, it's only 80 degrees outside. How does your car feel? It's
Right.
not 80 degrees in there, that's for sure.
Well, we call those environmental risks, don't we? Instead of personal risk. And again, those are the things. I mean, it's the radiant heat bouncing off the walls. It is the astroturf or artificial turf where the heat is bouncing off that. We know that it raises the temperature 10 to 15 degrees. When you brought up the warehouse, it's certainly, we have a client, and when I went up there, the internal temperature on the second floor where they store a lot of records and people have to go up and they work in there. So an office worker who's not acclimated goes up, works to find these old records, and they could be up there 30 minutes an hour, whatever it may be. It's 110 degrees up there, and it's like, because what's heat do? Heat rises, and now it's trapped in there. So how do you resolve some of those issues? Well, you can paint the roof, you can add a swamp cooler, you can add ventilation into the roof itself so that you're getting those. I love the big ass fans. Those are great.
Yeah, those are great.
Those are great. So
You
there's a
get the
lot.
proper training too,
Yeah,
for
you gotta have
you
the
get
training.
you let your office if your office workers aren't acclimated to that, and I don't see why they would, then you need to make them aware of that issue. Make sure that they're staying hydrated, make sure that they're taking a break after, if it's going to be a long exhaustive search, make sure that they're taking proper heat breaks and getting out of that environment if an engineering solution is not immediately present.
I got a better idea.
What's that?
Move the file storage to a proper location. I mean, scan it, for God's sakes, scan it. What are we storing all this fire
Why are
risk for?
we? Yeah, right.
It's unreal. Anyway, yeah, the heat illness is here. We got to do the training, of course. There's some thresholds in there. Remember, it used to be 85, now it's 80. You got 95 for high heat. 80, you got to have the shade set up. The indoor areas now are part of this. You got to monitor that. There's a lot of things that you can do. Just be aware of it. It fans, ventilation, attic fans, paint colors, the choice of the roofing material, all that stuff makes a big difference. And again, the radiant heat. I mean, in auto repair shops, you're dragging in hot cars, and now that hot car is, putting more heat into the room. So
And also
lots of.
consider the type of activity in that space as well. How strenuous is that work? How long are you going to be in there? Are you required to wear particular PPE that are fantastic for protecting from their given hazard, but they aren't helping you with keeping your internal body temperature cool?
Right.
You have to consider all these factors and ensure that you have the protections in place for yourself, for your people. Just always make sure that we're constantly remaining vigilant about that, especially at the height of hot season.
Yeah, definitely. So do your heat illness training, and I know everybody's been through it before, and it's boring, and you don't have to make it an hour. You can make it short, you can make it sweet, but we like to do a lot of hands-on. So I know, Matt, you just did one recently, and it got a lot of great reviews. And tell people a little bit about some of the things. Well, do we want to tell them or do we want to show them? I mean, I think it's better if they find out, but by actually doing it with us. I don't want to give away all our cool secrets.
Yeah, exactly. I think it's you make it fun and interactive for the people, and it's really easy to do that. There's plenty of ways to do this. For instance, you could demonstrate carries, because a lot of times with heat illness, someone is either going to lose consciousness or they're going to be weavy and unsteady on their feet, but you're
Right.
going to need to move them to shade. So how do you do that? A lot
Right.
of people don't know that. They don't know how to perform a swing carry or a drag carry or a chair carry. You're by yourself, or maybe you're with multiple people you don't know, but you need to get this person into shade.
I remember I
So,
went to Costa Rica. This is 20 something years ago, and I went with one of our insurance brokers, risk guys, and a bunch of other guys. And it was hot. And we were doing a hike. And right there, one of the guys was wearing jeans. And he just went right down. Boom.
Really?
Heat. Yeah.
Wow.
And
okay.
It was like, he landed. And then everyone turned to me. What do we do? What do we do? And I'm like, get his clothes off as fast as possible because we got to cool him down. And we weren't near water, right?
Right.
And we got to get him to shade because when he landed, there were fire ants everywhere.
Oh, wow.
So they
wow.
started biting him. Bam, oh, bam, bam. Wow. So it's like yeah. as soon as possible. So we all pick him up. Boom. We start running with him. And we move him. And we go to set him back down, you know, and fan him and cool him. And we're trying to find water and all this kind of stuff. And we're dousing his body with what water we have in our backpacks.
Right.
And then he gets woken up very abruptly from the ants biting him. But it was funny, you know, you don't think about it, but the clothing he was wearing was inappropriate for the hike.
Yes.
He had long pants on. That were, and then they were super tight around his waist.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, man, you know, you're cutting off all the circulation, you're holding, trapping in all this heat. So yep. you got to think about that. But I think the carries are important. Another thing is how to cool somebody down. You can demonstrate yep. that. How many times can you set up the shade or even take the temperature? Is this, you know, actually providing a cooling effect? You can have some water drinking contest. See, you know, mm-hmm. what their bellies feel like. Do that outside because sometimes people throw up. But
yeah, you know, yeah.
Like
<Good point.
laughs> we talk about the water and when you drink a lot all at once, how it just kind of runs through you. You don't really absorb it. So you can demonstrate that and have them slosh that around. I mean, a little more progressive than typical. Sit in class and
right,
but yeah, right. do those things. That makes the class a lot of fun.
Yeah, exactly. And that I, you know, that's we've done some other things, of course, with the with showing, for instance, where to put a cloth, the cold compresses, the ice packs against the victim's body, where that can be. Steve did a fantastic video.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you remember the video?
Yeah. Yeah, well, and again, you kind of got to put it to a jingle and make sure that
yeah,
people,
you mean, exactly.
You know, if you only have two cold compresses, where do you want to put them?
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes people put them in the wrong place. So there is an order yeah. to it. So you got to know that and
yep.
do it right. Absolutely. Yeah. Or you could just call us and we'll come out and do it for you. And we'd love
exactly.
to. We'd love to. We can do Zooms, of course. But yeah. And don't forget, we're offering 20% off to our new clients. So if you're watching this and you like us, you know, not only subscribe, but call us and
yep.
we'll do that 20% discount for you. All right.
Yeah,
with that,
touch.
Anything else on heat illness? I mean, it's time. It's certainly time.
Yeah.
This
is the time. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Look, it's July, but that doesn't mean, look, it's going to stay hot at least through October. Yeah. We had a lot of rain last season. There's
now
no
you sound
promises.
Like a meteorologist.
hopefully I have better predictions than they do, but look, I'd rather be prepared for the heat and then have it just disappear at the start of October and we don't have to worry about it anymore. I'd rather be prepared for it. So
well,
be prepared.
Being over 80 degrees is not hard to do in most areas of the United States at this point in time.
Yep.
So, all right. Yep. With that, we do have the online training. You find it on Dollar Training Club or Udemy. And if you need any other information, feel free to reach out to us. We'd be happy to answer any questions that you have. And we'll see you on the next episode of the Risk Control Show. Wait, I think it was Glenn Frey who did that song.
Was it Glenn Frey?
Let me see if
I don't know. I'm pretty sure it's Kenny Loggins. Was it Glenn Frey? No, I can't.
Hold on, it's Glenn Frey. Yeah. Glenn Frey,
okay.
Glenn Frey.
All right. There you go.
All
Kenny
right.
Loggins could have performed that song.